पैटर्न से होगा सर, पैटर्न का जो
क्लासिफिकेशन है
हाँ क्लासिफिकेशन से होगा। यस
ये सब नहीं हुआ,
सर।
ये नहीं हुआ सिंगल पीस पैटर्न, स्प्लिट पैटर्न।
सर आप बोले थे पर मतलब डिस्क्राइब नहीं हुआ था,
बोले थे मतलब डिस्क्राइब नहीं हुआ था, मतलब आई डोंट नो।
मतलब इतना ये जो पीपीटी है ये तक हुआ था ये क्लासिफिकेशन तक। हाँ उसके
बोलो
बाद जो
ये
डिस्क्राइब है ये वाला ये सब नहीं हुआ था सर।
सब नहीं हुआ था, मैच प्लेट
नहीं सर,
पैटर्न, देन कोप एंड ड्रग पैटर्न नहीं हुआ सब, गेटेड पैटर्न।
नहीं नहीं सर,
सो देन व्हाई यू टोल्ड मी दैट द पैटर्न इज कंप्लीटेड, मोल्ड इज कंप्लीटेड। बट आप लोगों का जो मोल्ड मेकिंग है बा पैटर्न मेकिंग है, पैटर्न मेकिंग, मोल्ड मेकिंग, पैटर्न मेकिंग, मोल्ड
सर
मेकिंग एंड कास्टिंग, वो वीडियो हो गया था, वीडियो कंप्लीट हो
हाँ
गया था।
वीडियो
वीडियो कंप्लीट हो गया था।
कब हो
हाँ
मोल्ड का वीडियो हो गया था सर, मोल्ड और कास्टिंग का वीडियो मेकिंग जो था वो हो गया था।
सर, लेकिन ये नहीं हुआ थ्योरी
नहीं सर,
में।
हाँ यस सर।
ओके तो ऑल ऑफ यू हैव ए पेन एंड पेपर, यस,
यस
सो
सर,
यू कैन राइट दिस वन इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट, सो यू कैन राइट इट। सो पैटर्न मेकिंग एंड फाउंड्री, व्हाट इज पैटर्न इन कास्टिंग, सो दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट, सो यू कैन राइट इट इन ए कास्टिंग। ऑल ऑफ यू हैव ए पेन एंड पेपर, यस
यस
यस,
सर।
ओके यू कैन राइट बिकॉज दिस वन यू विल बी हैव आस्किंग इन ड्यूरिंग द योर वाइवा व्हेन यू सेमेस्टर एग्जाम, ड्यूरिंग द सेमेस्टर एग्जाम दे आर आस्किंग दिस क्वेश्चन, सो दैट्स व्हाई यू कैन राइट इट फर्स्ट। व्हाट इज पैटर्न इन ए कास्टिंग, इन कास्टिंग ए पैटर्न इज ए रेप्लिका ऑफ द सब ऑब्जेक्ट टू बी कास्ट, यूज टू प्रिपेयर द कैविटी इनटू व्हिच this type of suppose initially I just show you that this is one of the design. So this is as a rectangular body. Okay. Suppose we have initially we have produced this type of body, then now we have to change the some dimension here. Suppose we have to put as a circle here, or you have to cut this part. Suppose we have to cut this part. So this is the possibility of to change the desired shape. Okay, so this is also one of the part of which we have. Okay, and the last point is number of casting to be produced. That is the possibility of repeat order. So this is also one of the important part for selection of the pattern material. Okay, second, the goods of its kind, pattern material which will be have, whatever the different qualities of chili pattern material is required. So easily work, shape and joint. Okay, this is the first point. Then light in weight, the weight, the pattern must be in the light weight. Okay, strong, hard and durable. So the pattern must be in a strong, hard and durable, but is a lightweight. This is a very important part, so that it may be resistant to wear, abrasions and to corrosions and to chemical reactions. That means the pattern is not any chemical reactions which will be given. Okay, now dimensionally be stable in all situations. The if you have a pattern is making any hot area, and then you have to use this pattern in a some cold area also. So that is the dimensionally be stable when the temperature which will be changed. Okay, so easily this is also the part which will be have considerable when the making the pattern. Okay, now the easily available at low cost, it is also very important part for the multi production system. If you have a multi production units, then you have to our main consideration which will be have to produce the pattern which will be have very low cost. Okay, then repairable and reuse must be used, reused basically when you making as any pattern, any material which will be used as a wood, or you have a metal or any other material. If you have a plastic, nylon, rubber, whatever the materials which will be used for the making the pattern, the reuse must be consideration. Okay, and able to good surface finish. This is also one of the main criteria. Okay. There are a variety of pattern materials. We are already discussed about that. Wood, metal, plastics, rubber, and the plasters. Okay. Now the type of patterns we are used for making the casting. First we have to make the mold, then you have to make the casting. Okay. So most commonly used type of which will be used for the single piece pattern, then split pattern. So you can write all the patterns, whatever the patterns we are used for any desired shape for the casting. Split pattern, then match plate pattern, cope and drag pattern, then fifth one is a gated pattern, loose piece pattern, sweep pattern, skeleton pattern, then segmental pattern, sail pattern. Okay, this is all 10 types of pattern we are used for casting. Okay, now first we have a single piece pattern. What is that actually? A pattern, you can write single piece pattern. A pattern is made without joints. The pattern is made without joints, partning or any loose pieces. So that means the pattern which will have a single piece, only the one piece which will be used for making the casting, then it is called as a single piece pattern actually. Okay, any loose piece in the construction is called the single piece or solid pattern. So it is also called as a solid pattern. A single piece pattern is not attached to a frame or plate and is therefore known as a, also called as a loose pattern. Okay, next we come to that. Split pattern. Split pattern means actually basically we have a, suppose here we have a one example which will be shown here, that this is a three part. One is the rectangular part, another is a cone type, and the third one is a cylinder type. So three pattern which will be combined or just fixed together to form as a one single pattern. So that is called as a split pattern. That three different patterns which will be made, three different shape of that pattern, and we have to join together so to form as a one single pattern, but we have a make as a different way. Okay, the many pattern cannot be made in a single piece because of the difficulties encountered in the molding. Okay, so here we have a put in a three molding boxes, and this three pattern which we put here, and we have to join this. Okay, that to eliminate this difficulty and to casting for casting of an intricate design of unusual shape. So the shape, so this is the usual shape, is a square or rectangular shape, but this three, two shape which will be unusual. So if you have put as a single piece, then it is very difficult to manufacture the single piece pattern. But if you have a three different pieces, we have first initially prepared, then we have to clap it or join it to each other by the screw or any other process. Okay, so split pattern are employed for to form the mold. This pattern are usually made in a two part, so that one part will produce the lower half of the mold and the other is the upper half. Okay, so here we are considering as a two part, but sometimes we are more than two parts also. That so that is one part which will be put in a upper half, and the middle one which will be put in as a middle part, and the lower one which will be put in the the lower part of the body. Okay, so lower part of this particular boxes. Okay, the two parts which may or may not be in the same size, shape and size. So this there is a three pattern which will be clapped together. So here is a three different size and shape which will be built. Okay, so this is called as a split pattern. Okay. Now match plate pattern. Match plate is basically is a one of the plate. Just like that. I just draw this one. This is the plate which will be have match plate. So this is basically called as a match plate. So this is actually called as a match plate. Okay. So this plate which will be put in a, so this is upper half which will be, suppose this is the split pattern here. These two patterns, suppose we are considering only these two parts. So this part which will be put here, the same things which will we have. This is very important part. Here, suppose we have a put as a rectangular box, or suppose not rectangular box, suppose this is a cylindrical box. Cylindrical pattern. Just cut here. Just put a cut here in this particular point. Okay, XX. And put put one half upper part which will be in this particular point here. Just put here. Okay. And the same places, suppose this is the axis which will we have considered. And the same places which will be put in the bottom part. Okay. So that is called as a match plate. This is a match plate which will be provided in between these two. Here which will be have match plate is provided. Okay, so that is actually used for the match plate. When the split pattern are mounted with one half of one side of the plate and the other half directly opposite on the other side of the plate, okay, the pattern is called as a match plate pattern. That is the between these two pattern which will be one match plate, or this is called as a plate which will be provided between these two pattern, the same pattern. Okay, but it is the two different pieces. A single pattern or a number of patterns may be mounted on a match plate. The pattern is made of metal, and the plate which will make the patterning of either is a wood or is a metal. So that means the pattern is made of metal, but the match plate is maybe made in a wood or in a metal. So that is called as a match plate. Okay. Now cope and drag pattern. So basically here have this is the two boxes we are basically used for molding the pattern. That is a molding molder actually used for this particular two boxes. The production of the large casting, the complete mold are too heavy to be handled by a single operator. Therefore, the cope and drag pattern are used to ease this problem by efficient operation. That is here. What is the happening? This is suppose this is the body which will we have casting. Okay, so we have put it as two pieces. This is a suppose this is a very large body. Suppose I give as a one example that in a steam engine connecting rod. In a steam engine, if you have see our steam engine, that the connecting rod is very, very large. Okay, yeah, just show you the connecting rod. I think you see that. So this is the connecting rod. Basically, we are. You suppose just we have a, there is a two pieces. Suppose I just cut this here, cut in this particular point. Okay, half of that particular connecting rod, upper half which will be put in the cope, and the lower half which will be put in the drag. So here this part. So then it is easy to handle. That upper part you handle one person, and the lower half which will be handle another person actually be hand, and put these two part which will be have. Form as a one single body. Okay, so that is called as a cope and drag pattern. Okay. Sometimes here I just show you that this one is also called as a cheek. That is the middle box. If you have a one particular, suppose here I just show you that, suppose I give you that, suppose here I just put it as a one, another particular shape which will have in this particular point, which will have put it as another shape or suppose, and I just cut it here and put in the cheek. So this is the three part which will have. Mostly we are used as a cope and drag boxes, but sometimes when the pattern is very, very large or you have to use as a more very large type, large size of casting, then we are used in the cheek part also. So here in this particular case, as I if you have show you here, this is the cheek. This is put in a cope and bottom one which will be put in a drag, but the middle one which will be put in a cheek. So this is the middle box which will be considered as called as the cheek. Okay. Now the gated pattern. This is another type of pattern which will be used for the multi-casting systems. That means when you have a multiple castings. So this is the pattern. There are so many patterns here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So we have a total 8 patterns which will be put. And one, this is called as a runner, and one gate which will be provided here. And the if you have a molten metal is 4, the all the molten metal which will be go to this individual pattern. Okay, so that means the pattern means we have a put as a molding, each and individual molding, and we just after the solidification we just take out from the mold, and we have what is a total 8 different same shape, different 8 multi actually. You have, if you have a multi casting system, then we are used as a gated type of pattern. To produce as a good casting, it is necessary to ensure that full supply of molten metal flow into every part of the mold. So this is the mold which will be have prepared after the pattern which will be making this particular point. Okay, providing provisions for easy passage of the flowing metal into the mold is called as a gating, which cannot be made by hand operation for high volume production. So this is, if you have a high volume production, then we are used like get a type of pattern. Now next, loose piece pattern. So here loose piece pattern is basically, suppose this is the shape which we have, this is the shape we have want to casting. Okay, but initially we have put it as a this shape of pattern. This is the shape, this shape of pattern is initially have prepared. This is the shape. Okay, so this is the shape which will be have initially. This is single body pattern. Okay, this is a single body pattern, and these two pattern which will be have prepared individually. Okay, not in close within these two, this main pattern. Okay, and put it here and join it here. This is called as a loose piece pattern. That is that these two loose pieces are joined in these two places and put prepared as a mold. Okay, then you have to take it as the individually. First you take it as these two loose pieces, and then you have to take it from and take it from the mold which will be have this the main pattern. Okay, so that is called as a loose piece pattern. Some pattern are produced as an assembly of loose component pieces. This is the loose component pieces. Okay, the loose piece pattern are needed when the parts is such that the pattern cannot be removed in one piece. So in this case is that the pattern is not removed individually, a single pattern. It is have you have to remove individually each and every pattern of that. Okay, even through it is a split, that the line is made one on more than one plate. Okay, so that is actually called as a loose piece pattern. Now the sweep pattern. The sweep pattern is basically what is that? So this is as a sweep pattern. Okay, this is as a shape of the pattern. Just put as a one of the post here. This is the box. This is the molding box. Suppose this is the molding box cavity, molding box, and we have a, initially we put the sand in every places here, each and every places we put the sand. Okay, and one post which will be put inside the molding box, and you have to we have clamped this pattern in this particular post, and we have to rotate it. If you rotate the all the sand which will be removed from this particular set, all the sand which will be removed from this set, and the, after the removing all the remove, it is formed as a cavity, and just pour the molten metal here. The pour the molten metal after solidify the body which will be cast in this set. So that is called as a sweep pattern. Symmetrically mounted mold and cores, particularly in a large size, are sometimes shaped by means of sweep pattern. So this is the shape which will be have provided. This is the shape which will be have considered as a sweep pattern. The sweep pattern consists of a board having a shape corresponding to the shape of the desired casting and arranged to rotate about a centripetal axis. So this is the, when the sweep which will be rotated, this pattern which will be rotated, it will form as a cavity of that. It means all the sand which will be taken out from this particular point and we have poured here. So that is called as a sweep pattern. Okay. Next is skeleton pattern. Skeleton pattern is actually, if you have a pattern is very, very large size. So then we have to put as a each and every skeleton which will be have in a put in a molding box and we have to form as a one board, single body. So that is actually called as a skeleton pattern. Pattern is very large casting, would require as a tremendous amount of timbers for a full pattern. So that is, there are so many woods or there are so many other materials which will be required to form as a single body. So that is actually called as a skeleton pattern. So that means all the parts which will be initially which will be prepared as a individual parts and we have to join together to form as a skeleton pattern. Okay. Then segmental pattern. What is that? The segmental pattern or part pattern are generally applied to a circular work such as rings. If you have manufacturing as a rings, then wheel rings, then gears. Suppose we, I just show you the gears of that. So this is actually basically, this is gears which we have. So this is gear. So if you have manufacturing this type of gears or casting this type of gear, then we are used as a segmental pattern. Or you have to manufacturing as a ring, casting of a ring. Rings, if you have this type of rings, if you have manufactured. Or you have a wheel rims. So this is a wheel rims which we have. So this is a wheel rims which we have manufactured. Then we are used for the segmental pattern. Okay. Now the next is tail pattern. Tail pattern is actually used, that is large for the drainage fitting and the pipe work. Suppose you have to put a manufacturing as a pipe. So this is the shape which will be have. Suppose this is the shape of the pipes. I just show you that. Suppose I just, so if you see that pipes, if you have a say, PVC pipe, if you have seen this, this is looking like that. So this ending part which will be have diameter is large. The diameter in the ending part is the diameter is large, but the middle part or the after that part which will be have as a less diameter as compared to the ending part. Suppose if you have prepared this type of casting which will be have used for this particular type of pattern, then we are used called as a sail pattern. So the here just this shape which will be have for form as a pattern here, and we have to put as a molding liquid metal here, and we come to the casting of that particular shape. So that here we call as a sail pattern. So that means the sail pattern is basically used when you have a casting as a pipe type, pipe or fitting works, so fitting type of work. So the construction purposes material we are used for making that particular pattern. Okay, sail pattern. Now pattern allowances. Okay, so this is this we are already discussed in our classes, in the last classes that when you during the video that we have a different types of allowances we are used. I just show you that what is called as the allowances. A pattern is a replica of casting, but it has slightly larger dimensions. Okay, this change in pattern in casting due to various reasons is known as a pattern allowances. So there are so many allowances when so many condition which will be required when you making the casting. So that means you have sometimes we are take as a draft type of that, or you have used as a more the pattern which will make as a more as compared the casting size. So that is actually then that is actually we have produced as a put as a allowances. Okay, so the different types of allowances which will we have that is called as a sinkage allowances, then draft allowances, third one is called as a machining allowances, then fourth one is a distortion allowances, and fifth one is as a ripping allowances. if you want, you can write. I just hello. Hello. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Have you want to write this individually? What are the allowances we are used for the pattern when you're making the pattern, or you just only that overview of that? Because as a IT student, this is not that required for this particular deeply knowledge about the allowances we are used. But if you want, I just told you that whatever that. Okay, if you want, you can write. Those who want, no, not those who want, all of you write that. I just told you that. Okay, first is thinkage allowances. Right, please. Thinkage allowances. As a metal solidify and cool, it sinks. SHRINK sinks, and it sinks and reduce in size, reduce its size. To compensate for this, suppose this one actually. So this is the pattern which will we have. Then after when the molten metal is poured, and after the solidify of this particular casting which will we have sinkage. This part which will we have sinkage. So that is called as a sinkage allowance. Okay. So right, please. To compensate for this, a pattern is made larger than the finished casting. To compensate for this, a pattern is made larger than the finished casting by means of a sinkage or construction allowances. Okay, now draft allowances. At least when a pattern is drawn from a mold, draft allowances. When a pattern is drawn from a mold, there is always some possibility of damaging the edge of the mold. When a pattern is drawn from a mold, there is always some possibility. There is always some possibility of damage the edges of the mold. This danger is gently decreases here. In this particular cases, I just first write that decreases if the vertical surface of a pattern are taper. Vertical surface of the pattern are tapered inwards slightly. This slight taper inward of the vertical surface, this slight taper inwards on the vertical surface of a pattern is known as draft allowances. Here, just we have to put in, if you have a put in a vertical surface and you have a remove this pattern, show you that when it is a remove from the molding box, it is maybe this particular part which will be have cracked, or if this particular part which will be have failed, or any distortion which will be given. So remove this particular conditions which will be have put in as a draft type of shape in order of this particular shape. Okay, so that is called as a draft allowances. Now next, machining allowances. The rough surface of casting that have to be machined are made to dimensionally the dimension sir sorry are made to dimension somewhat over this indicated somewhat over this indicated on the finishing work on the finishing work, full stop. The extra amount of metal, the extra amount of metal provided on the surface to be machined, the extra amount of metal provided on the surface to be machined is called machine allowances. So here, this is this part which we have put in as a allowances here. Okay, actually this is the shape of actually this is the actual shape of the casting, and this part which we have provided as a machining allowances. If you have after the casting, this part which we have machined by the machining, which will be have provided by the machine. Okay, so this is called as the machine allowances. Now fourth one is called as the distortion allowances. Some casting, because of their size, shape, and type, some casting, because of their size, shape, and type of metal, tends to distort during the cooling period. Tends to distort during the cooling period. So this is actually basically just first right. Tends to distort during the cooling period. This is a result of full stop. This is a result of uneven sinkage. This is a result of uneven sinkage. This is a result of uneven sinkage, and is due to uneven metal thickness. And due to uneven metal thickness, or to one surface being more exposed than other, or to one surface being more exposed than other, okay, the shape of the pattern, full stop, the shape of the pattern is thus bent in the opposite direction. The shape of the pattern is thus bend in the opposite direction to overcome this distortion. This feature is called as a distortion or pattern. This feature is called as a distortion pattern. So this type of distortion of casting which will be given. If we have a required shape of the casting, so this type of bend which will be have after the solidification of the body. So that's why we provide as a distortion allowances. Okay. Now next one is a ripping allowances. RAPPING, ripping allowances. When a pattern is ripped in the mold before it is withdrawn, when the pattern is ripped in the mold before it is withdrawn, the cavity in the mold is slightly increased. So this part, when it is ripped, so this part which will we have when it is put in this particular places. So this is the molding box, suppose, and we have a sand is there. Then after when you put it here, after the ripping which will be given, this part which will be extra, which will we have this part here, this side also, and this side also. Okay, so when the pattern is ripped in the mold before it is withdrawn, the cavity in the mold is slightly increased. In every cases where casting must be uniform and true to pattern, ripping or shake allowances is provided. Shake allowances is provided for by making the pattern slightly smaller than the actual size of the mold. Actual size of the mold. So that is called as a put as a ripping allowances. Okay. Now foundry. Foundry or casting is a process of forming metallic product by melting the metals, pouring it into a cavity known as the mold, and allowing it to solidify. When it is removed from the mold, it will be the same size and shape as the mold. Okay. A foundry is a factory, then I told you again. Okay. A foundry is a factory that produces metal casting. Metals are cast into shape by melting them into a liquid, pouring the metal into a mold, and removing the mold material after the metal has solidified as it cools. So that is actually basically we have used for the casting in the foundry. Molding tools and the equipment. Foundry tools and equipment, foundry tools and equipments may be classified into three groups: the hand tools, flax, and the machining tools. Okay. Sorry, mechanical tools. Hand tools, flax, and the mechanical tools. Hand tools. The hand tools are used in a foundry. The hand tools are used. Basically, there are so many hand tools who are used in the foundry. One is shovel, another is shovel. I just, you can write the shovel. What is that shovel actually called? A shovel is used for mixing and tempering molding sand. Shovel is used for, I just show you that first. This one also very important. What is that shovel actually? This is actually basically the shovel. The shovel is used for mixing and tempering molding sand and for moving the sand from the pile to the flax. So that is actually basically the sand which will be mixed. So that is why you use this particular instrument is called as a shovel. Okay. Then second, riddle. A riddle sometimes called as a screen. A riddle is sometimes called as a screen. Consists of a circular or a square wooden frame. Consists of a circular or a square wooden frame fitted with a standard wire meshes at the bottom. It is used for removing foreign materials. It is used for removing foreign materials such as nails, splinter of woods, etc. or short metals also from the molding or from the molding sand. Okay. Then rammer. A rammer, a hand rammer, is a wooden tool used for packing or ramming the sand into the mold. So that is actually basically used for the rammer. Okay. One end called the pin. So this is called as a pin, PWM pin. This part which will be called as a pin. One end called the pin is wedge shape, the shape which will be like as a wedge shape. And the opposite end called the butt. This is called as a butt. Okay. Has a flat surface. It is maybe circular or it is a flat surface. Okay. So that is actually basically for the ramming operation. Okay. Now next is trowel. A trowel consists of a metal blade fitted with a wooden handle. Trowels are employed in a order to smooth or slick over the surface of a mold. Okay. So that is actually basically when you have a finishing work of the surface, then we are used as a trowel. Okay. Then slick. It is a small double-ended tool. It is a small double-ended tool having a flat on one end, having a flat. This side is actually called as a flat end. Okay. One end and a spoon size shape. This is the spoon shape. Here you see we have this side is a flat end and this side is a spoon shape. And spoon on the other end. This tool is also made in a variety of shape. So there is a shape which will be different shapes which of slicks are used for the mold, for the casting purposes. Okay. For the construction purposes, we are also used for the slick. Then sixth one is called as the lifter. Right, please. Lifter are made of thin section of steel. Lifter are made of thin section of steel of various widths and lengths various widths and lengths. So that means there is so many lifters we are used for the different lengths and the size of that particular points. Okay. Widths, various widths and lengths with one end bend at right angle to each other. One end bend at right angle. Okay. They are used, full stop, they are used to clean and finish the bottom. They are used to clean and finish the bottom and the side of the dip. Finish the bottom and side of dip in mold. Narrow opening in mold. Okay. Next one is called as a strike of bar. So strike of bar basically which will be used for the surface finish of this particular when you put as a sand here and we have to remove the excess sand from the boxes. Strike of bar. The strike of bar is a piece of metal or wood. So it is maybe metal or it is maybe wood with as a straight edge. It is used to strike or strike off excess sand from the molding after ramming to provide the level surface. To provide the level surface, we are used for the strike of bar. Okay. Then screw pin. Screw pin. A screw is a, here I just show you that a screw where we put a, this is the screw pin which will be put here. This is the pouring basin, that means here we have put in the molten metal here. And this is the passage which will be have the molten metal is come to the screw well. Okay. So that is actually put a, this type of shape which will be have put here. In this particular point here we just put here. This particular point we have put it here and just to remove that from that. So that is called as a screw pin. Okay. So a screw is a taper pin pushed through the coke to the joint of the mold. The joint of the mold. Okay. Then sweep. A simple sweep is a small brass having long hip fiber, a bulb sweep has a rubber bulb to hold the water and the soft hair brushes at the open end. The sweeps are used for moisturizing the sand around as a pattern or for applying paint. So this is actually basically this is a brass type of that. So I just show you that this is the brass type of that and we just put as a take as a water from that and we just we have a molding box. Suppose here we have a sand. I just put as a just take as a water from that and just put in this particular surface of that and we have sand which will be used for the moisture. Okay. Then gate cutter. Gate cutter is a small shape piece of sheet metal commonly used to cut a runner. So this is I just show you here. And feeding gate for connecting a screw hole with the mold cavity. So that is actually used for the gate cutter. I just here. This is the passage which will be have. This is the runner passage and this is the screw passage. So all this passage which will be remove the sand by this particular gate cutter. Okay, this here. The gate cutter is a small shape piece from this type of shape which we have put in this particular point. Okay, shape piece of sheet metal commonly used to cut the runner and feeding gate. So this is the runner part. This is the runner part and this is the feeding gate which we have. Okay, this is the gate which will be also provided here and this is the runner passage. Okay. Oh, mallet. So we are already familiar about that tools. This is called as a wooden hammer. So that is called as a mallet. A raw hide mallet is used to loose the pattern in the mold so that it can be withdrawn without damage to the mold. So that is actually used for the mallet. Okay. And vent rod. So that is actually we have as a, this is a pin type of that which will be put inside, put here, and gases which will be removed from this. So that is how you use as a vent rod. Vent rod, right, please. A vent rod or wire is a series of small holes. So there are so many holes which will be provided in this particular surface of the mold cavity hole to permit gases to escape while is being poured. Okay. So that's why this type of tools which will be used for the every part of the body which will be have some put as a hole. Okay. So this used as a vent rod. Then spike or screw. The draw spike and steel rod with a loop at one end, with a loop at one end. So this is the looping which will be one end, and another side which will be have as a, okay. It is used to wrap from the sand. Okay. It is used to wrap and draw patterns from the sand. So this type of tools which will be used for the ripping purposes of this particular surface of the pattern. Okay. And wrapping plate. A wrapping or lifting plate. So that is actually, I show you that this is the plate which we have. Just put it here and just lift up the body. Okay. A wrapping or lifting plate is used to facilitate wrapping and lifting of the pattern from the mold. Okay. The plate must be firmly attached to a pattern by long screw or even bolt in the large pattern. This molder places a drawn spike in the wrapping hole and wraps it is to loosen the pattern. Then fix draw screw into the screw hole on the plate. Okay, so this type of instrument is also used in the foundry saw. Then split level, this is all of you have familiar about that for the split level. The split level is basically we have put in this particular point, surface, and we have to measure that the surface is horizontal or not. So if you have measured the horizontal surface, then we have put in as a split level. So basically we have that. This is the water level which we have. This is also called as a water level. That water level is provided here. And if you have a body which we have a horizontal surface, then the water which will be a level which we have in this particular point from here to here, the middle part of that. Okay, so that is actually a split level we are used most of the construction purposes. The last thing is here, molding box. This is very important. You can write also. Sand mold are prepared in a specially constructed box. Sand mold are prepared in a specially constructed boxes called flax. It's called as a flax. I just flax. Okay. Again, I told you the sand molds are prepared in specially constructed boxes called flax. The purpose of the flax is to impart the necessary rigidity and strength to the sand in molding. Full stop. They are usually made in a two parts alignment by the pin here. This is the two parts which will be put in this part which will be in this particular point. Okay. The top part is called the cope. The top part is called the cope, and the lower part, or because we call as a, not as a middle part, this is as a lower part is called as a drag, drag drag. If the flask is made in three section, if the flask is made in a three section, the center part is called the cheek. Cheek. These fluxes can be made of either wood or metal, depending upon the size required, depending upon the size required and the purpose, the flask must be served. And the purpose, the flask must be served. Full stop. The metal flask are used when production is large. The metal flasks are used when production is large. Otherwise, normally wooden flask is the most. Okay, so this is about our molding. Okay, now we come to the. Today we come to the welding. Faiz sir. Hello.
हाँ सर बोलिए
बोल रहा हूँ आज वेल्डिंग के बारे में कुछ बता दीजिए या ना क्या करेंगे आज शुरू कर देते वेल्डिंग
उसके बाद देखा दिया जाएगा नेक्स्ट क्लास में उसको कंटिन्यू फिर किया जाएगा
क्योंकि हमको तो क्या मैं व्हाट इज वेल्डिंग वेल्डिंग क्या होते हैं वो मैं थोड़ा सा बता देता हूँ अच्छा क्या क्या कितना टाइप का वेल्डिंग होता है सो वी कैन डिस्कस अबाउट द Do we have a, another part which will be called as a welding? Okay, so write please. All of you write please. Process of joining is the process of joining similar metals. Welding is a process similar metals by applications of heat. With or without application of pressure and addition of killer metal. Full stop. The result is a continuity of homogeneous materials. The result is a continuity of homogeneous materials of the composition and characteristics of two parts which are being joined together. Okay, so that is actually called as a welding. If you have anyone asking what is welding, then you can told the welding is a process of joining similar metals heat with or without application of pressure and addition of filler metals. Okay. Now write please. Weldability. 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 The term weldability has been defined of being welded as the capacity of being welded into inseparable joints having specified properties such as definite weld strength, proper structure, full stop. The weldability depends on one or more of the five major factors. First is melting point. Second, thermal conductivity. Third one, thermal expansion. Fourth one, surface condition. And last one, change in microstructure. And last one, change in microstructure. Okay. Now, next, type of welding. Next, type of welding. Modern methods of welding may be classified under by two categories. Under by two categories. One is under by two categories. One is plastic welding. One is fusion welding. F-U-S-I-O-N, fusion welding. They are also called pressure welding and non-pressure welding. That means plastic welding is called as a pressure welding and fusion welding is called as a non-pressure welding. Now, next para, right please. In the plastic welding or pressure welding, in the plastic welding or pressure welding, the piece of metal to be joined, I can check all of your copy after the class. I can check all of your copy after the class. Okay. Right, please. In the plastic welding or pressure welding, the piece of metal to be joined or heated to be joined. Metal to be joined or heated to a plastic state. To a plastic state, STAT state. To a plastic state, forced together by external pressure. Then forced together by external pressure. Full stop. This process is used in forge welding, resistance welding, resistance, 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 resistance welding, thermite welding, thermite, thermite welding, and gas welding. Gas welding, in which the pressure is required. Next paragraph. In the fusion welding or non-pressure welding, The material at the joint is heated. The fusion welding or non-pressure welding, the material at the joint is heated to a molten state. The material at the joint is heated to a molten state and allowed to solidify. This includes gas welding, arc welding, thermite welding, etc. This includes gas welding, arc welding, thermite welding, etc. Now come to the gas welding. Because in our course, we have only gas welding and arc welding is there. Now gas welding first. The gas welding is done by burning a combustible gas or oxygen in a concentrated flame, FLAME, flame. Full stop. Welding methods as with other welding methods, purpose of the flame is to heat and melt the parent metal and filler rod of a joint. Full stop. It can weld most common materials, equipments. It can weld most common materials, comma, equipments in expensive, versatile, etc. So now we can next class we start the oxyacetylene gas welding. Okay, oxyacetylene welding. So Fahid sir, you can see any part of the gas welding? Have you seen the welding shop or any the different parts of the welding? Fahid sir.
Okay sir.
हाँ ठीक है, आप दिखा दीजिए थोड़ा सा, स्टॉप शेयरिंग करता हूँ. स्टूडेंट्स हैव एनी क्वेश्चंस अबाउट दैट? एनीवन? स्टूडेंट्स हैव एनी क्वेश्चंस अबाउट दैट? एनीवन? अनिस?
हेलो सर.
हाँ यस
सर, द यू प्लीज सेंड द पीडीएफ सो दैट वी कैन रिवाइज.
Okay, okay, I can tell you that. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Thank you. Okay, I can stop. You can continue here. Fahid sir, you can.
Okay, sir.
हेलो हेलो.
यस सर.
हाँ कुछ प्रॉब्लम हो रहा है संजय? आज क्या हुआ? हेलो 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 संजय ठाकुर. संजय जी.
हाँ हेलो सर, बोलिए.
क्या हुआ? स्टॉप.
ये सर स्टार्ट हो
रहा
है. ठीक है ठीक है ठीक ठीक. हेलो स्टूडेंट, एम आई ऑडिबल? स्टूडेंट
यस सर.
हैव यू सबमिटेड योर लैब रिपोर्ट? व्हाई योर क्वेश्चन? वेयर विल यू सबमिट? Isn't?
Yes, sir. Exactly.
Have you prepared or not?
We have not got yet.
अभी किस किस के पास है?
सर हमारे ग्रुप में नहीं दिया गया है, मतलब F1 बैच में नहीं दिया गया है अभी क्लासरूम।
अच्छा तुम लोग पास जिस जिसके पास है पूरा लिखा है हेलो
शायद अलग ग्रुप में हो
जी,
सकता है,
मतलब अलग ग्रुप में हो सकता है, मतलब
मतलब F1 को छोड़ के, क्योंकि F1 में अभी तक दिया नहीं गया है क्लासरूम में।
ओ नहीं वो मैं नहीं बोला बात, तुम लोग फिजिकली प्रिपेयर कर लिए हो लैब रिपोर्ट को
नहीं तरह
है?
नो सर।
तुम लोगों को जॉब सीट मिला है?
नहीं सर, नहीं सर, नहीं।
जॉब सीट नहीं मिला है? अच्छा ठीक है, एक लड़का जो अपना ग्रुप का एक ये भेजो कोई भी मेल आईडी, ठीक है उसमें हम जॉब सीट भेज देंगे, ठीक है चैट बॉक्स में भेज दो और रवि सर जो है दिखाएंगे तुम लोगों को, ठीक है वाली मैसेज के बारे में।
हेलो स्टूडेंट, सी द वेल्डिंग शॉप, दिस इज ए वेल्डिंग शॉप, यू कैन सी दिस पिक्चर। हेलो
Yes sir.
Yes sir. Yes sir. Okay. Ah, this is a arc welding setup. देखो ये one of the arc welding setup. AC type transformer. Main source of the power for arc welding.
This is the welding shop. Okay. This is arc welding machine. Welding table. Welding table. विजुअल स्टूडेंट
ओके यस सर
This is MIG welding setup, MIG, CO2 mag means carbon dioxide, mag means metal active gas, okay. This is the cylinder, CO2 cylinder. Actually, this is the MIG welding setup, okay. MIG welding setup, this is wire feeder. Okay, another setup is gas welding, oxygen cylinder and acetylene cylinder. Okay, hose pipe, welding torch. Okay, another welding setup, arc welding also. Arc welding setup, welding table. Okay, today I am discuss about welding, arc welding. Okay, arc welding equipment one by one discuss. First one is power source, AC or DC. AC welding machine, alternating current. Okay, AC, and DC means direct current. The first one is power source, AC or DC. There are two types of inside transformer. Two types of transformer, step down and step up. Okay, inside step down transformer, and here is four pole. Work means negative, and holder means positive. Okay, the first one is power source, AC or DC, inside transformer, and cooling of transformer, method of cooling, two types of cooling, oil cooled and air cooled. Okay, this is oil cooled, inside oil. Okay, and next one, welding cable made of copper or aluminium. Okay, this is copper, made of copper. Okay, next welding cable, and next welding table. This one welding table, earthing claim, electrode holder. This one electrode holder, this one welding electrode, okay, welding electrode or filler material. Next one, welding helmet. Next, chipping hammer. Okay, actually this is a tong. Okay, T-O-N-G, tong means local language Sarasi. This one chipping hammer, after welding remove the slag with the help of chipping hammer. Okay, this is the slag, before welding flux. Okay, two part of electrode, one inside metal and outside coating, flux coated. Okay, this one core wire, and specification of electrode, dia and length, diameter 2.5 mm minimum and length 350 mm. Another size of electrode, 315 dia and length 450 mm. Okay, types of electrode, two types of electrode, bare and coated, and consumable and non consumable. Okay, this is consumable electrode. Okay, and this one apron for safety of your cloth. Okay, apron for safety precaution. And this is welding helmet, protect of eye. Okay, hand gloves, for protect of your hand, both left or right. Okay, now types of welding, arc welding, gas welding, MIG, TIG, submerged, thermite. Okay, types of welding joint, butt joint, T joint, lap joint, corner joint and edge joint. Okay, just a simple piece of butt joint. Okay, two pieces metal and देखो middle position में welding. This is your job, welding job. Single knee butt joint. Okay, simple piece. This is welding. Permanent joint. Okay. Okay, the types of joint, butt joint, T joint, lap joint, corner joint and edge joint. And types of welding position, flat or downhand position, vertical position, horizontal position, overhead position and inclined position. Okay, welding technique, leftward and rightward. Leftward technique means right to left and rightward technique means left to right. Okay, leftward technique means, example, this is electrode holder and this is a welding electrode and position of welding, left to right means left this side and right this side, means leftward technique, left to right, rightward technique. Arc welding is rightward technique, starting left and right. Okay, and gas welding leftward technique means starting right and ending left. Okay, now temperature of arc welding 6000 to 7000 degree centigrade and temperature of gas welding 32 to 3500
degree centigrade. Okay. Definition of welding. Welding is a process of joining two similar metal by application of heat with or without application of pressure and addition of filler material. Okay.
Udyan, are you present, Udyan?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Have you gotten it?
Yes, sir.
Okay, you have to send your group.
Okay, sir.
Okay, and okay, then sir, you write the lab report.
Okay, sir.
You know how to write?
Yes, sir.
You know how to write the lab report?
Sir, we will see from our F2 group.
Okay.
Okay, sir.
You have seen from, and then you will submit as quickly as possible. Okay.
First, sir, we'll submit. Yeah,
sir, we have class test tomorrow and
we are having exam. Fourth
and fifth. Submit next class or after that? Okay, when will you start your test?
4 and 6.
कल से है?
हाँ सर.
ठीक है, तो कल क्या क्लास सस्पेंड है, कुछ ऐसा बोला गया है? हैं स्टूडेंट्स?
सर, वी डोंट नो.
क्लास सस्पेंड है, कुछ ऐसा रिपोर्ट है तुम लोगों के पास?
हाँ सर, अगर कल एग्जाम होगा तो शायद क्लास नहीं होगा.
जब क्लास, जब एग्जाम होगा तभी क्लास नहीं होगा. ठीक है, तो तुम लोग लैब रिपोर्ट को रेडी करके रखोगे, ठीक है ना? जैसे टाइम मिलेगा, मान लीजिए ये हफ्ता तुम लोग का एग्जाम चल रहा है, टेस्ट चल रहा है, तो उसके बाद से जो है तुम लोग लैब रिपोर्ट लिखना शुरू कर दोगे. ठीक है?
सर, ठीक है,
ठीक है ना?
ठीक है सर.
ठीक है, तो आज के लिए इतना ही है. ठीक है, और कोई क्वेश्चन अगर वेल्डिंग से या फिर रिलेटेड है तो बोलो, नहीं तो फिर अगले क्लास में कंटिन्यू चलेगा ये वेल्डिंग.
सर, ग्लास गैस वेल्डिंग, वेल्डिंग का टेम्परेचर कितना बोले आप?
ऐसे 3200 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड है. मतलब ये जो है हम लोगों का फ्लेम पे डिपेंड करता है, हम लोग कौन सा फ्लेम जो है प्रोड्यूस कर रहे हैं. 3 टाइप का फ्लेम होता है, ठीक है, न्यूट्रल फ्लेम, ऑक्सीडाइजिंग फ्लेम, कार्बोराइजिंग फ्लेम. ठीक है, ऑक्सीडाइजिंग फ्लेम में सबसे ज़्यादा टेम्परेचर रहता है, न्यूट्रल फ्लेम में सबसे कम टेम्परेचर है, तो वही 32 मान के चलो. ठीक है
सर, तुम लोग ओके सर,
यही है मतलब 32 ही. जब तुम लोग से क्वेश्चन किया जाता है वाटर, ठीक है ना, जब क्वेश्चन किया जाएगा टेम्परेचर कितना राइज होता है ड्यूरिंग गैस वेल्डिंग में, तो 32 डिग्री बोल सकते हो, 32 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड.
ओके सर,
ठीक है, तो इस वीक के लिए इतना ही था. लैब रिपोर्ट अगर किसी को कोई डाउट होगा तो मेरे नंबर पे या सर के नंबर पे फ़ोन करोगे, लैब रिपोर्ट को दिखा दिया जाएगा, ठीक है ना? लेकिन अगले वीक में यानी टेस्ट के बाद जो है कोशिश करोगे रेडी करने का. ठीक है
सर, नोट सेंड कर दीजिएगा.
नहीं, वो शेयर नहीं किया जाएगा, वो भले तुम लोगों को दिखा देंगे, हम लोग जॉब शीट शेयर कर दिए, ठीक है ना?
नहीं नहीं सर, जॉब शीट नहीं, जो नोट्स आप लोग मतलब हम डिस्कस करते हैं.
ओ अच्छा अच्छा अच्छा,
पीपीटी
वाला.
हां पीपीटी, ठीक है, हम वो भेजेंगे.
ठीक
है, पहले हम फिटिंग का भेज रहे हैं, ठीक है ना? ठीक है, तो पहले फिटिंग का मैं भेज दूंगा.
ठीक है सर.
ओके सर.
हाँ, तो एक ही लड़का जो मेल दिया है उसी में भेजूंगा, सब उससे कलर कर लोगे. ठीक है
ओके सर.
ओके. Now you can leave. Hey, hey, give your attendance. Okay. Sabhi attendance de do chat box mein.
Maji sir.
अटेंडेंस अभी सर बोला अभी करूँ
क्या बोला
ऑफ कर दिए क्या
आयुष्मान गिव द अटेंडेंस इन चैट चैट बॉक्स ना चैट बॉक्स